Hi chicas, how's everyone doing? Welcome back. I hope everyone is doing good. Today we're going to be working with this teal design, so then let's begin with the acrylics. We're going to be using Sweet Tooth by Not Polish. You guys know that we have a discount code, so take advantage. I'm also going to be using Warm Glow, which is number 155, again from Not Polish. Everything will be in the description below, you guys, just in case you guys are interested. Like I said, we do have a discount code, so I would definitely take advantage of it. So again, everything will be linked in the description box. Okay, chicas, so now right here, I'm beginning with my nails prepped for the video and everything. So I'm going to begin by applying. This is a nude from Not Polish. How many times have I said Not Polish? My God. Okay, this is a nude. So I'm going to be applying it all over the index finger. I am so sorry that the camera was a little blurry here, you guys. I'm totally sorry. I was really, like, literally working as much as I could. And I did not realize that my camera was totally unfocused. I am super, super, super sorry. But, I promise that I'll keep an eye on it next time. Now here on the middle finger, all I'm going to be doing is applying this teal minty color. I don't think it's a teal, you guys, or you guys tell me what it is. To me, I look at it more as a minty color. But honestly, you guys, I love minty colors. I freaking love them. So I'm going to be applying this color all over this middle finger, you guys. And I want you to notice the consistency of their acrylics. Remember that they're 2-in-1. You can use them as dipping powder, or you can definitely use them as a regular acrylic. I am using them as regular acrylic, you guys. I'm using them with regular monomer. And you can totally see here the consistency of them. They are so creamy. They are so, I don't know how to describe them, you guys. They're just super easy to work with. They're super beginner friendly free. So if you're a beginner and you're just beginning in this nail journey, these, I highly recommend them for you guys, because they're not fast drying or anything. They just settle on the nail, you know, really not slow, you guys. I'm not saying that they dry on the nails slow, but it does give you, you know, a lot of time for you to mold it as much as you want and to the place that you want it to be at. So now on the ring finger, I'm gonna be applying again the nude color. So I just start off like from where I glued my tip to my natural nail. That's where I begin, the apex area. That's what it's called. So that's where I'm beginning right here. And then I place another bead right here on the cuticle area. And then I brush it down towards the tip of the nail. And that's how lately I've been working, you guys. That's how I've been working with my nails. Even I don't have clients, like I've said before. Right now I don't have clients at all. But my sister has came here to do her nails, and this is the way that I've been working lately. Before, I used to begin at the cuticle area, and for some reason I just started doing it this way, and I prefer it much more. I prefer working like this. So it's really up to you how you work, you guys. You know, however you feel most comfortable with, that's how you want to work, you know. So now on the pinky, I'm just going to be kind of doing like a marbly thing there. It's not going to be really a marble. Well, I mean, it is a marble, because I am kind of marbling those two colors together. But you guys want to make sure that you don't marble them as much, because you don't want to, you know, make it into one weird color. You know what I mean? So just try to, like, I guess pick up one bead and then kind of marble it, and then pick up another bead. I don't know, you guys. I have different techniques for this, but this is the way I'm doing it right now. Not my favorite. I just want to mention, not my favorite. But, you know, I decided to leave it because, you know, even though I have seven years of nail experience. You know, I'm not perfect, you guys. I still struggle. I struggle with ombres. I struggle with marbling. I struggle, you guys. And I learn as I go with you guys. So, you know, I'm not perfect and I am not a pro. I've said this a lot of times before. So I just want to get that clear, you guys, that even me with a little bit more experience, I do make mistakes. So yeah, you guys, now onto the index finger. I'm going to be doing like a V French. So I'm going to be taking my Gelixseed foil gel and I'm going to be applying it like as V shape onto the index finger. I hope that makes sense. I hope you guys can kind of see what I'm doing here. And in the middle, on the middle finger, my Chuntis accent just came out of nowhere, you guys. But onto the middle finger, I just applied it onto the half of the nail. So right here, I'm just going to be taking this beautiful foil. And I'm going to be placing it here where we did the V shape. Remember to cure that in the lamp for about 60 seconds. I've tried it with like 30 and 40 seconds and it doesn't work, you guys. Well, for me, and it might be, you know, the type of UV lamps that you have, because mine personally is a 12 watt, the one that I use for myself. The ones for my clients is a 48 watt lamp, so it does take a little less time to cure. So I guess you just gotta try and see what works best for you. And, you know, like I said, what kind of lamp you have. So it all depends. So now I'm gonna be moving on to applying some crystals. You guys know that a design needs crystals because, I don't know, you guys, crystals just makes everything look better. And if you made a mistake, it's like you wearing lashes. If you made a mistake with your eyeshadow and you don't like your eyeshadow, you put on your lashes and bam, girl, like you're looking hot. Nothing seems that's wrong with your eyeshadow. It's like that with crystals. If something went wrong with your application, crystals will make it better, trust me. So I'm using my Zulay adhesive to adhere these crystals onto the nails. You guys know, by far my favorite. So everything is gonna be linked in the description box, just so you guys know. And if you guys wanna go and check out their stores, everything again in the description box. So I'm gonna be applying some onto the ring finger and also onto the pinky. I was about to leave the index finger as is, you know, just with one little stone, and then I was like, no, girl, like, that does not look right. It's like, it needs more crystals. So I went ahead and added more crystals onto that finger. And I'm just going to go ahead and add my top coat right now. So I'll be back with you guys whenever I'm going to be applying my top coat. So yes, chicas, after all those crystals are laid down on the nails, we're gonna go in and use our Glossed by Knot polish. Oh my god, you guys, this is one of the best, if not the best, top coat out there, you guys. It's literally one of the best. I love the consistency. I love the shine it gives to your nails, how long it lasts, because my sister has used this on her nails and it has lasted. So it is by far, really by far, one of the best out there. So, you know, I have not really used many, there's a lot out there in the market, and I haven't used, you know, every single top coat. But I have tried NSI, I've used Kara Sky, I've used some from, you know, eBay and AliExpress. Let me see, I've used the D&D. I've used several, you guys, and I honestly, by far, this is one of the best that I have and that I have tried. So yeah, you guys. So yes, you guys, we've come to the end of the design, and I really hope you guys enjoy it. I hope you guys like it, and if you did, don't forget to like, comment, and share, you guys. Please share the videos, every single video, guys. Please go share it with anybody, you guys. Please share the videos. And if you're new here, please don't forget to subscribe as well. Thanks for being here. I'll see you guys on the next one. Stay safe, God bless, and bye-bye.